recording today. We're finally going to get a test. I've been wanting to do this for a while, but I haven't had time. To test the cup car. This thing somehow managed to win. It wasn't the fastest car. I just completed everything, but it's got all this aero and stuff. It's only got 20 more horsepower from the last one. Just hit this. Let's see what it does. That puts it actually at the top now. Right in front of the road car version of this car. Next challenge. Alright, now it's time to try this on a racetrack. It's kind of meant to be. I'd expect this to get second or first.
Actually,
I was expected to beat the P2000, but it lost a couple seconds. Because it was just unstable on that little hill right there, and it comes off. But it was 2 seconds faster than the T500 touring car, which has like 50 more horsepower. My big V8. I think it's lighter though. I mean, it's not that light, actually. Much heavier than I would have wanted this car to be, but next challenge. Now I'm trying to test this thing on this road course. A bit unstable doesn't really make me more. Oh, that's the right word for it. Does not like these roads. And the point was that it was going to reflect in the time. Race cars would do worse on these actual roads that are actually bumpy. And would do better on Trial Mountain, which is all smooth. Surprised the softer suspension and more grip would do a bit better here. Which is why I had so many issues with the conditions of each car. See which one's better. Now barrels rolling for air. Will it land it on its wheels? Oh, it stuck the landing. P2000 beat it again. But it beat the P500 touring car, which is also a race car, and the P3000, which is just unstable. So yeah, not too bad. I mean, second place isn't bad in any world, so. Some may even call it the best. Anyways, next challenge. Alright, time to test this in the quarter mile. Well, here, because, well, look at that, it's at 2 lanes. This is supposed to be good for a track, and that kind of slows it down in the quarter mile, but it has 20 more horsepower than the original semi-slick, so it might do better. 11.9, that's not too bad of a time. It's quite good, actually. I can't see it compared to the other cars, but I imagine it puts it pretty high up. Alright, next challenge. Alright, time to test this on Rally stage. Probably gonna skip most of this because it's just gonna be uninteresting. See? Uninteresting. Dread the most in cars like this. Still, I'm gonna drive fine. This is just the one. It's not interesting unless there's a rally car, and most of the time there isn't a rally car because I don't make too many of those. I mean, I had a couple earlier on. I'm still kind of early on in this series compared to the amount of cars I still need to do. I'll just stop doing this series and instead do it in my free time. I like doing it. Car with lots of power. Anyways, next challenge. Alright, time to test this thing's top speed. Probably lowered by the metal wheels. Also gearing. I purposely geared it short, but then I had to gear it longer because each wheel spins too much. So. And I mean, I understand that. It was mostly for the AI. Might have hurt my drive, the drivability to me too, but... Should max out in like 183, I'd imagine. Pretty close. Ribs left, unless it's not gonna rev all the way. No, I was wrong. 185, 86. Seemed close though, if he's gonna top out of it. You touched 186, so I'm gonna say it's 186. I'm not gonna test this in on the autocross course. I feel like it's gonna have some issues with this spin. And those are fenders are giant. Thank you. 144.9. About 145. I'm not going to bother seeing what it is. Next challenge. I'm going to come test this off-road. Oh, look, it's refusing. It's refusing to go that way. I'm trying to fight it. Oh, it crashed itself because it didn't want to go off-road. Absolutely wonderful. Anyways, next challenge. Alright, trying to test this on West Coast. Still hasn't been updated. Up. Lost the front splitter already to a curb. This will happen eventually. Big update. Well, some other stuff from CTs that hadn't been added yet, so.
And then she just wasn't done.
Imagine, I want to hope it's going to be coming out in like a month or two. Earlier the better, but. I'd imagine it'll be coming out in a month or two. That sounds kind of reasonable. Enjoy this part just because of FPS. It's a decent track. Pretty decent, it's good. I mean, I put it here just to like test because I suppose it could change because it's not bumpy. Because these roads are kind of flat. Well, not flat, but they're kind of smooth, but they're not flat. That's what I wanted to say. So, like, this isn't flat right here, but. It's smooth. So it does is going to help. Also, with the with better suspension, that can kind of soak up the bumps a bit better. Especially the times where it's air. It's also not many places where you can get some good speeds. So it also kind of sees how well the car can handle and take bumps. Front wing could have helped there, but I would have lost it 15 different points in this track already, so nothing I could have done about that. I was going to lose it. I say wing because it's technically in the wing section, so it produces downforce. I would test to see if it actually is true that only wings produce downforce, but I honestly don't understand that much about aero and beam. So I don't think I'm qualified to do that kind of testing. And I imagine they're correct. Oh dear. Active weight reduction came in a bit too late. It's got fourth though. Barely. If I didn't crash, I could have probably beaten 450, but the 450 probably also went. I don't know. I can't remember. Anyways, next challenge. Alright, time to get this challenge done.
Thank you.
6 minutes, the TS500 touring car did, P2000, P3000, but 4th place puts it in the top 5, 5 seconds faster than P1000. So, I was expecting this thing to do a bit better. 3rd place in the racetrack, though, was exactly what I'd expect. It was kinda, I feel like the push rudder suspension wasn't the best at handling the bumps on this track. Because this track is kinda bumpy. It's not completely smooth. It's smoother than Utah, but it's not as smooth as Trial Mountain, so that kind of, I feel like the pushrod suspension doesn't handle those bumps nearly as well. But yeah, that's not too bad of a time. It's still a very fast car. You did see some issues with trying to, like, you know, wheel spin. These are the max these tires can be, and you look at those are definitely, like, these tires are, like, half the size of them. very close after size to the rear ones. The rear ones are max size that you can have, and they're still just not enough for this amount of power. At least with the way its power is. Probably with, it could probably be fixed with gearing, but then gearing would make it slower. I only made the gearing as long as I needed it for an AI to complete it, because realistically I'd want it to top out at like 150, because it shouldn't need to go much higher than that. And I feel that the race car shouldn't have that high of a top speed, because technically, you know, like, they need that gearing more for the low end, because there's not too many racetracks you get to use that speed on. There's Spa, Le Mans, we don't have Le Mans. Doesn't really matter. So yeah, that's it. Goodbye.